Hello, this is Brian from Head in the Box. This is not a live program tonight. Don't have enough time to have a full program, but I'd like to present to you something I think is very important after watching Meet the Press today with Chuck Todd. Of course, today's date is November 25th. Chuck Todd had a full panel discussion concerning climate change with Elise Jordan, Donna Kearns Goodwin, Danielle Pletka, and Helene Cooper. I had a real problem with Danielle Pletka. Now, she's from the American Enterprise Institute, and she's very, very conservative, and she has her facts wrong. And unfortunately, Chuck Todd didn't press her on this, but I will. So in the beginning of the broadcast, or the part of the broadcast where they talked about climate change, Pletka says, the problem for many is that they perceive this as an agenda that is much more about corporate and much more about law and much more about the kind of governance that America has and much less about climate. So from the standpoint of those who have doubts about this, I don't think we can have any doubts that there is climate change, whether anthropogenic, I don't know. I'm not a scientist. Well, this is the kind of statement that conservatives like to throw around these days. You know, 5 or 10 years ago, they would say things like, yeah, the planet's probably warming, but we're going through cycles. We've always had cycles, and this is just another one, and we should accept it. Well, no, the previous cycles were deep time cycles over millions of years. In our case now, this is happening over very short periods of time, so it was a lie. So now she's throwing around this, well, yes, we're not quite sure whether it's anthropogenic or not, okay, as if it really mattered. But the truth is, it is anthropogenic. And then also she's alluding to the idea that this whole climate change movement is more about politics, more about let's do in Trump. Well, I don't think we have any problem going against Trump on other issues. This issue has to do with survival, extinction of animals, extinction of humans. It's making the world miserable already. And for her to say that this is more of a political thing is complete rubbish. She goes on later in the questioning by saying, I look at this as a citizen and I see it so I understand it. On the other hand, we need to also recognize that we just had two of the coldest years, the biggest drop in global temperatures that we've had since the 1980s, the biggest in the last 100 years. We don't talk about that because it's not part of the agenda. The United States has been dropping CO2 emissions since we pulled out of Paris. Well, here's some more bullshit coming out of her mouth. Just absolute bollocks. So, again, anybody who knows anything about climate change knows there's no such thing as the two coldest years. We did not go through the two coldest years. In fact, I think 17 of the last 18 years have been the warmest on record. Complete crap. And I don't know why Chuck Todd didn't stop her right there and put an end to it. But he let her go on. Then she said, we've had the biggest global temperature drop since the 1980s. Again, crap. It's increasing. And it shows, obviously, in the Arctic ice extent. And then it says, also the biggest in the last 100 years. Absolutely ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. I think the last really cold year was probably during World War II, you know, when the Russians during the winter against the Germans. That was probably it. And then she ends with that statement, the United States has been dropping CO2 emissions since we pulled out of Paris. Well, that's crap in general. I mean, there's a certain truth to it. Yes, in 2017, emissions, CO2 emissions in the United States decreased, but it was at a much, much lower level of increase than under Obama in 2016. And then the projections for 18 show that the CO2 increase will be positive or greater next year. So that's kind of like a half lie. So she's just throwing things out there. Let's move on. And it gets worse. She said, there are actually good things that are happening. We're not using dirty coal anymore. It's the Europeans who are using dirty coal. There's actually some corporate leadership on this. Yes, we need to deal with these problems. Yes, we need to, I'm not able to see this very well. We need to mitigate the things we see, but we shouldn't be hysterical. Well, hysterical in the sense that what you're saying is going to make me hysterical. We should be hysterical. We need to not lighten up with this. There's no such thing as clean coal. Coal creates more carbon dioxide than any resource, at least that I know of. And above that, even when you're mining coal in the process, it creates methane. So this idea of clean coal is just absolutely absurd. And for us to be accused of being hysterical is kind of ridiculous. That's absurd, completely absurd. So in the end, this is the kind of thing that we're seeing in the mainstream media. And I'm glad that NBC is starting to push this issue. I know CNN has, MSNBC, which is obviously a part of NBC, but they're not doing a good enough job. And I like Chuck Todd for the most part. He knows a lot about politics. But on this issue, he should have immediately stopped her in her tracks and told her she was wrong. And nobody else actually piped in. They did on the Khashoggi issue. But on this issue, they stayed away, and that was it. So this is why we have something called the Reality Report on Head in the Box, because there are certain things that are not going to happen in the mainstream media. And I like some of the mainstream media. I do like MSNBC. I do like CNN, for the most part, with their coverage. And they are starting to talk, again, more about climate change. But there are times when you have to stop people in their tracks when they're going to outright lie. And Danielle Pletka is a liar, and she should be stopped. And on this program, she will be. Thank you.